Well, this week's by-election win for the Green Party on Vancouver Island left one of BC's most prominent New Democrats issuing a blunt message to his own party. Svend Robinson, the longtime MP seeking a return to Parliament this fall, took to Twitter and warned that the NDP's loss of its seat in Nanaimo-Ladysmith was a wake-up call for the party. And joining me now is Svend Robinson. Good to see you.
Andrew, good to be with you.
You know, you called Monday's by-election a wake-up call, as I just mentioned, for the federal MP. What did you mean?
What I meant is that the issues in that by-election were obviously a concern around, a deep concern around the climate crisis, concern around inequality. We had a great candidate in Bob Chamberlain, a respected Indigenous leader. But what I was hearing on the doorstep in Nanaimo-Ladysmith, what I'm hearing in my own constituency in Burnaby North Seymour, is that we've got to be much more bold and much more outspoken on the issue of the climate crisis. Jagmeet Singh, as the leader of the party, has taken a clear stand recently around a number of the important issues, around fracking, around the UN Declaration of the Rights of Indigenous Peoples, calling for an end to fossil fuel subsidies. But I think Canadians are looking to us to take a strong stand. And I said it was a wake-up call because the NDP lost a seat that we had held and we came a distant third. So there's still time to turn that around, to take that seat back, but we've got to step up.
So the party says, you know, Mr. Singh has been consistent when it comes to the environment and climate change. You know, what else specifically beyond what you just mentioned do you want to see Mr. Singh latch onto?
Well, as part of the overall platform, I think that we've got to recognize the sense of urgency to the climate crisis, and that really we've got to be going on a wartime footing, like we did in World War II, to respond to this crisis. Earlier this week, not only was there the by-election, but the Pact for a Green New Deal was launched, and I think that that captures that sense of urgency. Specifically, there's concern around the federal position, the federal NDP position on LNG. And I think we've got to recognize that if we're going to meet those climate change targets, certainly the British Columbia government is doing really important work around the Clean BC initiative, which is leading in the country. But we've got to be clear on LNG and say that it just it doesn't meet the test of responding to the climate crisis.
Is that a view when it comes to LNG that you think is widely shared within the NDP?
I have, since I tweeted a few days ago, and I specifically referred to LNG, Site C, I've heard from New Democrats across the country, Andrew. There's deep concern about the results of the by-election, but also a real sense of hope that we can turn this thing around because, you know, the Greens have focused on climate change, and that's great, and I give them full credit for that. But we as New Democrats are saying we've got to tackle the climate crisis, but also we've got to recognize that the challenge of inequality. And so Jagmeet is speaking out, and all of us have been speaking out on a national pharmacare plan, on the importance of a massive response to the crisis of housing, dental care, child care. That's what sets us apart from the Greens, and that's what we have to focus on together with the urgency around the climate crisis.
Now, you're planning to run again in Burnaby. You're going to be running right next door to Mr. Singh this fall. Do you have any concern that when you speak out like this, saying that the party and Mr. Singh needs to do more, do you have any concern about blowback from the party in terms of your own nomination or your own place in the party?
Not at all. No, I mean, we're a Democratic Party, and I know that Jagmeet shares the concerns. I mean, he spoke in the House just last week eloquently against fracking, calling for respect for UNDRIP, saying no more fossil fuel subsidies. All I'm saying is that as we roll out our platform, and that's going to be hopefully in the next few weeks, let's recognize that the voters of Nanaimo-Ladysmith sent us a message. People across Canada, I think, are looking to the NDP for that leadership, that bold and visionary leadership on the climate crisis, on the Pact for a Green New Deal, and on inequality. And I'm confident that that as we get closer to the election, and hopefully soon, those are the issues that we're going to be campaigning on.
And finally, you know, you were talking about how you think the NDP needs to confront the challenge of both a Liberal government and, you know, the rise of the Green Party, which we saw in this this week's election. So let's talk about Trans Mountain, because if the federal government ends up giving approval, final approval to that project this spring ahead of the next campaign. How would that affect the party in terms of the NDP and how you're going to campaign in British Columbia? Do you see an opportunity to perhaps find some kind of ground in between the Liberals and the Greens?
Well, there's a huge sense of betrayal with Justin Trudeau and the Liberals in my constituency, the Liberal MP, who promised that Liberals will not allow Trans Mountain to expand. The Kinder Morgan pipeline expansion won't go ahead unless the community agrees and there's Indigenous support. They betrayed both of those. They bought the bloody pipeline, for God's sake. It makes no sense whatsoever. They used the old Harper environmental assessment procedure. So that, of course, will be a huge issue. If they are foolish enough to try to proceed with this, Indigenous peoples, the Tsleil-Waututh, who are in the heart of my constituency, Indigenous peoples across the country, New Democrats, Jagmeet Singh, has spoken out very, very strongly and clearly against Trans Mountain, and the Liberals are going to pay a huge price if they try to push that through.
All right, Svend Robinson, thanks so much for your time, and we'll speak again soon.
Good talking with you. Thank you, Andrew.